गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस जॉब एप्लीकेशन, वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स इन योर राइटिंग स्किल. स्टूडेंट्स, यू ऑल नो वेरी वेल दैट देर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ लेटर्स. ओके, बिजनेस लेटर्स, लेटर्स टू एडिटर एंड जॉब एप्लीकेशन. बट दिस टाइम ड्यू टू COVID-19 सिलेबस हैज़ बीन डायरेक्टेड. ओके, एंड नाउ CBSE हैज़ डिसाइडेड टू पुट ओनली टू लेटर्स इन योर सिलेबस. फर्स्ट वन इज job application and then letters to editor. Job application and letters to editor. Earlier we had 6 marks for job application. Okay, to attempt letter we have to score 6 marks, but now CBSE has deducted from 6 to 5, so now you will get 5 marks. Now you will get 5 marks and it is in long composition. Fine. So you have only you can say 3rd number question advertisement notice, then 4th number question invitations and replies, and 5th number question you will attempt this job applications or letter to editor. Job application is a 5 mark, and I know that you would like to score 5 marks very well. So basically, what is job application? Whenever you will go through any employment notice, okay, whenever you see an employment notice, okay, if you are eligible for that post, definitely you would like to apply for that post. अगर आप एलिजिबल हैं तो आप उस पोस्ट को अप्लाई करेंगे. सपोज इन केस यू हैव कंप्लीटेड योर एजुकेशन, योर यू हैव अचीव्ड योर टारगेट, ओके, यू हैव रिसीव्ड योर डिग्रीज, देन यू विल गो समवेयर टू अप्लाई. एंड दिस इज द मेन थिंग दैट वी हैव टू राइट बिफोर अ जॉब. वेन एवर वी आर अप्लाइंग फॉर ए जॉब, वी हैव टू ड्राफ्ट एन एप्लीकेशन फॉर द पोस्ट. सो स्टैंडर्ड पैटर्न, वॉट इज स्टैंडर्ड पैटर्न फॉर जॉब एप्लीकेशन, आई विल टेल यू, एंड इट विल ऑल्सो हेल्प इन योर फ्यूचर. सो जॉब एप्लीकेशन, वॉट इज जॉब एप्लीकेशन एंड मीन्स एप्लीकेशन वी आर राइटिंग, ओके, वेन एवर वी वुड लाइक टू अप्लाई फॉर अ पोस्ट. जब भी हमें अप्लाई करना होता है, वी हैव टू राइट डाउन जॉब एप्लीकेशन. ओके, एंड जॉब एप्लीकेशन consists of 2 parts. First is covering letter. We can say covering letter or cover letter. It is up to you. Covering letter or cover letter. And second one is biodata. Biodata, you can call it CV, you can call it resume, okay, whatever you would like to call, you can call it. So covering letter or cover letter and biodata. Fine. And job application and job. A job application. In an application means job application, we have to make 2 category. First is covering letter and second one is biodata. So job application consists of 2 parts, covering letter and biodata. Fine. So what we are going to mention in covering letter and what we are going to write in biodata, how will we draft biodata, I'll tell you. Okay, first of all, you have to understand the format of covering letter. Now we will understand the format of covering letter. Okay, so covering letter's format is similar to formal letter. Okay, format of covering letter is similar to formal letter. Okay, format is similar to formal letter. Same pattern as we are following in formal letter, same pattern we have to follow in cover letter over here. First of all, we will write sender's address. Then we will mention date. You all know very well that date word is not to be written. Okay, so what date is today? 25th October 2020. It is not necessary to write down TH over here. Okay, So 25th October 2020, better date you have to write in expanded form. We will not write 25-10, no. You have to write it in expanded form. Date you have to write it in expanded form, and you will not write this word date. You will not write this word date, update word nahi likhenge. Okay, then after date, what will we write? We will write leave line, receiver's address. Receiver's address, fine. Then you will write receiver's address. Okay, then leave line. After receiver's address, now in formal letter we are following what? We are writing subject. But I would like to suggest you what, that in whenever you are writing what, job application, whenever you are drafting job application, so in that application or in that letter you have to follow the pattern what? Salutation plus subject. Means you are not going to write subject over here. I want you to write first of all salutation. Dear sir, respected sir, respected madam, and then you can write down subject over here. Okay, self address, date, and then receiver's address, and then salutation. Okay, and then mention subject, then mention leave line subject. Salutation you can use dear sir, dear ma'am, respected sir, respected ma'am, and then you will mention over here subject. What will be subject? And application for the post of, an application for the post of, you will mention an application for the post of, you will mention this, an application for the post of, then you will write down your post, then leave line. Okay, and from here you will start writing body. Body of the job application will be in three paras. Okay, means standard format is three para, you can write in four para also, three to four paragraphs. I'll make you understand that what you have to write in these three paras, and then at last complimentary clause. What will be complimentary clause? Subscription. What is subscription? Yours truly, yours sincerely, yours faithfully. We can call it complimentary clause, or we can call it what? Subscription. Okay, so you will write over here yours sincerely or yours faithfully. You are advised not to write yours truly. Okay, you are advised not to write what, yours truly, yours truly. You have to write down yours sincerely or yours faithfully, complimentary clause or subscription. And below it you have to mention your signature. Okay, and then your name. It is the pattern of cover letter. It is the pattern of cover letter. Self address, then date, then receiver's address, leave line, then salutation. Okay, and subject. If you are writing subject over here, it is also right. Okay, it is not wrong. But I want you to write in this way. Okay, it is a standard format. Salutation, then subject, then leave line, then body. Then yours sincerely, oblique yours faithfully, and then signature and your name. It is the pattern over here. Then signature and then name. Fine. You have to write in that way. Students, now point to be noted for the subscription and what we have to write in body. Okay. We have to understand what you have to write in body and what you have to write in right below subscription. So, over here, after yours sincerely, can you note this point that I'm not using after yours comma? Generally students are using comma over here, it is wrong. Okay, you should not use comma over here, apostrophe comma. Yours sincerely or yours faithfully, both are correct. Yours sincerely or yours faithfully. Suppose in case you are writing sincerely yours, then you have to write down in this way. S will be capital. S will be capital. Fine. But what I would like to mention over here, the first letter will be capital. The first letter will be capital. Rest of the words will be in a small letter. You are not going to write in this way, Y capital and S capital. It will be wrong pattern. We have to follow Y capital and then rest of the letter will be in a small. In the same way, if you are writing sincerely yours, then you can write down S capital, sincerely yours. Okay. You can write down yours faithfully. Y will be capital and F will be small. Faithfully yours, F will be capital and Y will be small. So it is the pattern. Fine. Now, after yours sincerely and yours faithfully, what are you going to write? What you have to mention? So yours sincerely, you have to put your signature over here, signature, and then name. Fine. Below name, what you have to mention? After your name, then you have to mention and closers. And closers, it is not mandatory, but it gives a meaning to your job application. Why? Because in enclosure you have to mention that what have you enclosed along with the job application. It is a way of writing job application. Suppose in case you have attached your CV, you have attached your mark sheets, suppose in case you have attached your recent photographs, so you have to mention over here enclosures. What will you write? Biodata, then recent photographs, then you can mention over here biodata, recent photographs, and at last you can mention what? Testimonials. Okay, so it is the pattern of writing job application. Self, sender's address, date, receiver's address, then salutation, dear sir, respected sir or madam, then subject, then body, and then at last yours sincerely or yours faithfully. Put your signature, the name, enclosures, biodata, recent photographs and testimonial. After this, what you have to mention? Iske baad mein aapko kya mention karna hai? Biodata. But prior to biodata, I would like to tell you what you have to write in body. And body is of three parts. First paragraph 1, paragraph 2, paragraph 1, second paragraph, and third paragraph. Okay, so in first paragraph, what are you going to mention? Mentioning the source. It means in first paragraph, you have to mention the source. From where have you collected the information? From where have you received the information about this job? Suppose in case from Times of India, from some reliable sources, so you have to mention in first paragraph. This is referred to your, ऐसे ही लिखते हैं, this is referred to your advertisement number published in Times of India on dated. So you have to mention the source, from where have you got the information related to that job. Okay, mentioning the source, then date, on which date have you received the information, in which newspaper, and then also apply for the post. Then also apply for the and apply for the post. Fine. So first para is mentioning the source, apply for the post. Second paragraph, how are you perfect candidate. Means, how can you say that you are perfect candidate? Means, in second paragraph, you have to brief yourself. You have to give your details. What do you possess? Suppose in case I have done my MA, I have done my MSc, I have completed my MCom from that university, percentage, brief idea. Okay, then what do you possess? I possess what? A strong dynamic personality. And you have to brief yourself. So first paragraph, the source from where you have get the information about the job. Second paragraph, how are you perfect candidate for that post? Means why are you applying for that post? You have to mention. Second paragraph we can split in two. If our details are more, then we can split in two paragraphs. And third paragraph, refer your what? Biodata. Refer your biodata or photographs. Refer your what? Biodata, photographs. Refer your biodata, photographs. Okay, recent photographs. Okay, don't put your 10th class photographs. Refer biodata, photographs, and after it means mention one on one interview means request for one on one interview. Request, please, I shall be available for the interview if you are comfortable, and please allow me, or I shall be available for the interview at the time convenient to you. Aapka jo time hai us samay mein interview ke liye aa jaunga. So first paragraph, mention the source. Second paragraph, your detail. Third paragraph, refer to biodata ki humne, I have enclosed my CV for your kind consideration. Okay, I shall be available for the interview at the time convenient to you. Okay, so we will mention it. And at last, yours sincerely. Then put your signature, then name, and then enclosures. So it is the way of writing for what? Covering letter. Covering letter is important because cover letter is the first impression on the person. ओके इन द कंपनी वेयर आर यू अप्लाइंग फॉर. जहाँ आप अप्लाई कर रहे हैं, आपका कवर लेटर आपका मिरर है. कवर लेटर इज द मिरर ऑफ योर जॉब एप्लीकेशन. इट विल गिव अ व्हाट यू कैन से एट अ ग्लांस व्हाट आर यू. एट अ ग्लांस आपको उनको समझ में आ जाएगा व्हाट आर यू. सो कवर लेटर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. देन वी हैव टू मेक बायो डाटा. ओके सो व्हाट इज बायो डाटा? बायोडाटा होता क्या है? और CV, करिकुलम वाइटे और रेज्यूमे. एक्चुअली बायोडाटा इज व्हाट? योर पर्सनल डिटेल. ओके, एजुकेशनल क्वालिफिकेशन डिटेल, वर्किंग एक्सपीरियंस वी हैव टू मेंशन. बेटा सी, देर आर डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ द बायोडाटा CV, एंड वी कैन मेक इट अकॉर्डिंग टू अस. वी हैव टू मेक अट्रैक्टिव बायोडाटा. बट जनरली हाउ अ बायोडाटा इज टू बी drafted, that I am going to mention over here. Fine. So you will write for after enclosures, you will write bio data. Okay, and you will underline it. Now it is a system to write what? Name, father's name. I want you to write leave a little bit margin, and from, you will not start from margin, you will leave little bit line from margin, and you will start from here. Email, first of all you will write your email. Then name, personal details. Name will be in capital. Okay, capital letters. Then father's name, only your name. Then father's name, suppose in case father's name you have to write, then name word we are not able to write name word over here. So you have to write name below fathers. Okay, why? Because we have to write it in proper sequence. We have to write it proper. It's not their father's name here you are writing, so it looks you can say dirty. You have to make it in a standardized format. Email, name, father's name, then mother's name. Okay, mother's name. Then after mother's name you will write your date of birth. We can split biodata in three parts: personal details, educational qualification, and working experience. Okay, so then date of birth, expanded form. Marital status. What is marital status? Your status of marriage. Married or single. Don't mention single or double. Married or single. Okay, you have to mention married or single. जो भी है आपका वो आप mention करेंगे. Then you have to write down your address and languages known. Languages known. You have to write down languages known. So it is the way of writing personal details. Email, name, father's name, mother's name, date of birth, marital status, address, and then language. Nationality, we can mention over here, nationality. These words are important in biodata. Means you have to mention nationality. You have to mention what? You have to mention nationality. You have to mention your idea of languages known. Then nationality. I'll give you a proper format of biodata. Okay. So you can prepare it for your exam. Nationality. Then languages known. Fine. After this, you have to write down your educational qualification. Educational qualification. So, suppose in case you have your highest degree is what? M.Com or MBA. Okay? Or MSc or M.Com. Whatever. Suppose it is your highest degree. Now, you have to make a tabular format. You have to make a tabular format. Why? Because your education should be drawn in tabular format. Serial number, class, board or university. Okay. So it will give at a glance your educational qualification. Board, university, percentage, okay, and at last year. Serial number, class, board, university or degree, class, and then percentage, year. Suppose 1/10 board CBSE, percentage 98, year 2009-10, whatever you have to mention over here. Then 12th, then you have to mention in that format, because this educational qualification plays a vital role in your job. Because for the job, wherever you are applying, person should know who is giving you a job. Okay, so he should know what is your qualification and how much you have scored in your exams. Then after educational qualification, so first we have make personal details, then we have made what? Educational qualification. Then if it is although it is not mandatory, you will mention work experience. If you have work experience, then you will write down work experience. Okay, work experience. But in work experience, you have to write down from present to previous. How? Presently working as a senior manager in HDFC. In HDFC, whatever post, presently working in Bharati Public School, presently working in Delhi Public School, whatever. And then you have to mention your post in HDFC since 2014-16, whatever. Then you have, suppose in case you have also previous work experience, then you have to mention worked at Indusland Bank as sales manager for 3 years. For 3 years. For consecutive 3 years, for consecutive lagatar 3 years. So it is the way of writing work experience. Work experience we have to mention in this way only. Presently and then previous. We will not write on first work desk. First of all, we have to mention where we are work, where are we working, and then your previous experience. So personal detail, second education qualification, third is work experience. Okay. And after work experience, if you would like to quote your salary, then you can quote it. Salary means expected salary. What you expect from the company. Okay. Expected salary. Expected salary means 7 lakh, 5 lakh, 10 lakh per annum, or 80,000 or 90,000. Whatever, per month. And then you have to mention this word, negotiable. Means what? This is it is an etiquette. It is an etiquette. If you are not writing negotiable, it's okay. But you have to mention negotiable word, because whenever we are applying, so we should not be adamant over there. We have to mention quote our salary, then we have to write down negotiable word. Negotiable on table. Negotiable. Why? Because it is important. Suppose in case person would like to give you 75, then it can be negotiable, and you are in need of that job and you want to join that company. So you have to write down negotiable word. After this, what? Work experience. Now, beta, it is journal format of the biodata. It is journal format of the biodata. Then you will mention references. Then you will mention references. It is, you can say, soul of the biodata. Why? Soul of resume, biodata. Why? Because without it, your biodata is not complete. We have to mention at least two names. Okay. Although we are mentioning only two names, only standard format, two names whom you know and they have good position in the society. Mr. XYZ, director. Mr. XYZ, don't pronounce director, director. Mr. XYZ, director. Director. PNB. Okay, whatever. Then second, Mr. XYZ, or mention phone number. Mention phone number, okay. Then Mr. XYZ, okay, CEO, IndusLand Bank, means your previous company, you have to mention this, okay, and then phone number. So references we are going to mention at last. You have to mention your references. So first you are writing personal details, second you are writing educational qualification, work experience. And in biodata, we can add objectives of life, step challenges. In biodata, we can write hobbies. But journal format is what? Personal detail. And in personal detail, write from your name, parents' name, okay, date of birth, marital status, and nationality and languages known. And then work experience, if you have. Educational qualification, we have to mention it in tabular format. And at last, references. So it is the proper format of biodata, okay. And we can add more things, objectives of life, and then you can add hobbies, you can add what, your career or orientation program, and all you can mention it. So we have done our this format of covering letter and biodata. Now we will do questions on job application, okay. And I want you all to go through this pattern, and it is very easy, you can go through it, okay. Aap aaram se padh lenge, because this is very scoring for your exam. Thank you. Have a nice day.